Disclaimer, I'm stepping into some pretty spicy territory here, as Murder Mystery has a very large and defensive community. So, like, this review is satire, to a certain extent anyway. It's still my opinion, after all. Let me start this video off with a simple question. Remember Murder Mystery? You know, that game? The one by Nicholas that started the whole murder game craze that refused to die out for a good 2 years? Not that I particularly blame Nicholas for accidentally starting a trend, but let's just say it was a dark time for the front page of Roblox games. A really dark time. The basic concept was completely stolen, graciously borrowed from a custom game mode on Gary's mod titled Murder, in which there are three roles. Innocent, which does absolutely nothing, Murderer, which has to kill all of the innocents, and Sheriff, which has to kill the murderer. That's about it. It didn't take that long for Murder Mystery to fade into obscurity, though, as other games such as the Mad Murderer, Twisted Murderer, or even Clone Troopers game simply called Murder completely dethroned it. Thus began the Great Murder Game War of 2014. Eventually, though, after these other games were finally starting to die out, Nicholas was working behind the scenes on a sequel that literally nobody asked for. As 2015 dawned upon us, so did one of the most unnecessary sequels of all time, Murder Mystery 2. Upon launch, the core gameplay really wasn't different at all. Aside from nicer looking maps, a cleaned up interface, and a lot of cosmetic changes, there was nothing worth considering this a full sequel. Obviously, this changed as time went on, but have those changes really been for the better? The prime difference you'll notice between 1 and 2, at least when playing casual mode, is that it has really lost sight of its original purpose. The game seems to be far more concerned about you buying skins, perks, toys, pets, radios, and monetizing pretty much anything it possibly can than making sure the actual gameplay stays true to the original. The game in its current state just reeks of a corporate lust for money. This couldn't be more obnoxious. Whether the game is pestering you to buy the Elite Game Pass, Shadow Item Pack, or just buying more currency, it seems like it really can't give you a break. On the bright side of things, though, you always have the option to play hardcore mode. This prevents you from encountering a bunch of spoiled Builders Club members blasting their obnoxious pop music on their 2500 Robux diamond-plated quantum radios, but the pestering still isn't completely unnoticeable.
Hey there, buddy! Welcome to Murder Mystery 2! In order to have a better gameplay experience, why don't you buy Elite? Maybe buy our new crates? Buy the Shadow Item Pack? It's only 1300 Robux, my friend! Perhaps you want to buy Elite for only 499 Robux? What about a radio for only 475 Robux? Gimme money! Gimme money! Gimme money!
Give me money!
Oh, did I forget to mention the trading? Yeah, this is one of those games, as in one of those games where the trading system is one of the prime reasons why the game still has such a hardcore community to this day. Not that this is inherently a bad thing, but it kind of coincides with my point about how the game has lost focus of its original idea. Although, that's kind of ironic, because I think this review has lost focus of its original idea. Can we just get to the actual gameplay already? Upon entering the game, you get a loading screen, because apparently that first loading screen just wasn't enough. Really? And despite all that, there's still a ton of completely missing assets and textures. We're off to a great start. Afterwards, though, you're actually given some options. You can play the standard mode, hardcore mode, or assassin, which is literally just a carbon copy of the Roblox game with the same name. Whatever. For this review, we'll be going with the standard mode, as it's, well, standard. I really need to stop saying standard. I will give another shout out to hardcore mode, though, as it's the solution to a lot of the criticisms I've been mentioning thus far. So, since I already explained the core concept of Murder Mystery, let's talk about the experience itself. I'm honestly unsure of what I can even say about it that I haven't already been saying multiple times. It's been completely corrupted by over-monetization. The worst part of it is by far the radio. I have no idea what it is with Roblox games and being so obsessed with radio game passes, but Murder Mystery 2 sure is no exception. For having mystery right in the title, the default game mode sure has a distinct lack of it, with the ability to go third person, a lack of disguised characters and names, and constant obnoxious music being blasted. You've got yourself a very contrasting and unpleasant experience. It feels like the game can't decide what it's trying to be. It has all of the right elements to be a legitimately mysterious game, but just doesn't work with these over-the-top game passes and toys thrown into the mix that just end up making it look totally goofy and ridiculous. The game genre is horror, after all. after all. There's also a pretty noticeable lack of polish overall. Again, this seems to come from a lack of focus on the core gameplay. These probably sound a bit nitpicky, but like I said, it falls under the category of polish, not necessarily something game-breaking. For example, at the beginning of the round, when the game is telling you whether you're innocent sheriff or murderer, they all play the same sound effect, a friendly ding sound effect, which seems like it was intended for innocence. Seems like a pretty basic detail that was just omitted for some strange reason. Even the mad murderer got this right. Additionally, the coins scattered throughout the map frequently clip through walls, floors, and even ceilings. It can be a little bit distracting at times. I think a nice solution to this would be to simply have the coins lying on the ground instead of spinning around in midair. It could also help optimize the game a little bit, as I'm sure having tons of coins spinning around constantly isn't exactly the most stable thing in the world for a Roblox game. Another thing that caught my attention is how abruptly a round ends. Everything just instantly disappears and it teleports you back to spawn with almost no indication of what actually happened until about 5 seconds later. It's yet another thing that almost feels unfinished. But hey, I'll cut the guy some slack. After all, who needs polish when you can just
give them money, buy the new crit pack, get it on!
Despite all of my constant criticisms, Murder Mystery 2 really isn't a bad game, but I don't think it's a great one either. The concept is certainly there, and there's a lot of fun to be had with hardcore mode, as I mentioned before, but the crazy lust for money injected into it is impossible to not notice. Nicholas is just lucky he got the genius idea to add hardcore mode, because without it, this game would probably be getting a 4 out of 10. This was supposed to be the part where I make a joke about Murder Mystery 3, because a while back, Nicholas tweeted a teaser for a supposed upcoming Murder Mystery 3. However, I was completely unable to find any picture of this tweet no matter how hard I tried, so, the joke is kinda ruined. I'm just going to put a random image on screen now to make up for it. Thanks for watching, I guess.
Hey everyone, it's Gordon Ramsay here. Make sure to leave a like, comment, and to subscribe to the Epikrika community to get more fresh content from our kitchen. Make sure to click the little bell icon to get notifications from our channel in the future.